Hello dear students, I am Dakshesh, teaching since 1989, I have 28 years of teaching experience. Over a period of time, I have been teaching programming languages, basic, Fortran, COBOL, Pascal, C, C++, Python and Java. So, vast experience in teaching, also associated with people working in IT sector. So in touch with people and their requirement, their needs in IT, aware of it. Accordingly, I change, I adjust myself every year in teaching. Okay, so this semester you are going to learn Python programming language. You are already familiar with C and C++. Python is having some features of C++, but besides, it has many more additional features. Some of them are listed out here. The first one, as it is given here, you can see, it's given, it's simple, very easy to code in Python language. You are aware of syntax of C and C++. Python, there are a lot of syntax of C and C++ have been eliminated. So definitely it's a great boon, you can say, or advantage you can say from programmer point of view. Python, as it is given in next point, open source. What do you mean by open source? Like any programming language, normally you want to buy, okay, you have to pay for it. Python is the language for which you don't have to make any payment. It is freely available. You can just download it by going to the site www.python.org. It is available on several platforms. The next point, it says platform independent. Further, if you see, it's given both software and hardware. Python is a major programming language, as you can see, it is used today in market in the IT sector. Though it was invented in 1991, but then it really speaking, it captured market since 2014. Now it is it has almost captured market. One of the point which we'll come to, you can see from here, we're used by very big companies like Google, Facebook, Instagram, Yahoo, and there are many more companies. Okay. So it is today in IT sector, it is Python is a major programming language. B.Sc IT from B.Sc IT point of view, since you are in IT, okay, so you will be going for a software job later on IT sector. So from IT sector, just C++ not enough. C++ is just to start with, to learn programming concepts of procedural and object oriented. But from job point of view, job perspective, you need to learn Python and Java in depth. In depth. You might have learned C++ just upar se, but learning Python and Java in depth is very much necessary. Then and then only I can say you will be eligible to go for software job. So that is a one very important point for which you definitely need to go for coaching, extra coaching apart from college. I don't want to go for why apart from college you want to go for extra coaching. You are well aware of it, what is done in college and what is done in coaching classes outside of your college. You are well aware of it. Okay, so you need to learn Python in depth. Open source, freely available, you can download it anytime, www.python.org. Platform independent. It is platform independent language. Platform independent means all the software, all the operating systems like Unix, Linux, AS/400, then Windows 8, all the operating systems that are available today in the market, they support Python. Python is inbuilt. Okay, so you download it. It is available on all the operating system. Also, it is given, it is hardware independent. You write program on one machine and later on you feel that you want to run it on some other machine, some other system, machine that supports some other operating system. Definitely you don't have to bother, you don't have to make any changes absolutely in your program. Program you have written on one machine can easily be executed, can be run on another machine without making any changes. So that is what is called as Python is platform independent. Next point, it says it is a portable language. Portable language, actually these two points are related to each other, which I have given. Platform independent, you write program, it is software independent, hardware independent. There is no dependency on operating system, on the machine on which you are writing. And as I said that it can be run on any platform, it is a portable language. It is called as a portable language. Next point, as you have done C and C++ both the languages, okay? So you are aware, you are familiar with functions. Python supports both procedural and object-oriented programming language features. It supports features of functional programming languages as well as it supports concepts of classes and objects, inheritance, polymorphism, etc., which are done in C++ in object-oriented programming languages. Let me tell you that Python is much, much beyond this. You combine C, C++ and one side you keep Python. C, C++, I can say in percentage, if I compare the C, C++ on one side, Python on other side, I can just say that learning C, C++, you just know 20 to 25% of Python, okay? 75% of features of Python you need to learn in depth in your subject Python programming language. A few features, if I tell you about Python which you need to learn, you have done programming with arrays, okay? One dimensional array, two dimensional arrays. There you have noticed that you can't, once the space allocation has been done for an array, space allocation has been done, during runtime cannot be modified, you cannot increase or decrease the size of an array. Comparing the same concept of array of C, C++ in Python language, there is absolutely no concept of arrays, but there is a new concept which Python has given called as a list. It is a dynamic concept. Dynamic meaning initially there will be no data, during program run as a user you can just go on adding data into your list. It is called as a dynamic concept. This is just one concept of Python I have told you. Related to list, there are some more concepts like dictionary. You don't have any such concept of dictionary in C, C++. There is a concept of tuple, there is a concept of sets. You have done at introductory level in C language file handling. You know, if you have done file handling, you notice that file handling, we use file when we want to store data in large volume on a disk, right? Okay, so this is there in Python. If you have done in little more depth file handling, you might have noticed that inserting new data into a file, once file has been created, adding new data, updation, changing some data, deleting, removing some data from a file is very, 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 very difficult. Python gives you some concept of database management system. It gives you connectivity with languages like Oracle, Sybase, and many other languages that gives you a database management system. It gives you interface, it gives you connectivity to such database management system. There is a concept called as MySQL. Using this concept of MySQL, as a user, you can store data in tables. Once data is stored in table, can be anytime modified later on. You can add new data into it, you can delete some data into it. These are some of the features which I have told you about Python. Learning Python in depth from B.Sc. IT point of view is very, very, very much required. Learning Python definitely will help you a lot later on when you go to semester 4, learn Java programming language. When you go to industry for a job, for an interview, you know C++ and you go, you say that I know C, C++, definitely some person sitting in front of you to take an interview definitely will say bye-bye, hello, we'll meet next time. You know Python, Java, definitely I can tell you that 99.99% you will have all the chances to get a nice job in an industry. So that's all today introduction. Later on, if you definitely, I'll be very happy that if we meet in our classroom. Bye bye, see you, thank you.